right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive studio. And joining me on Skype right now is Dale Ginn, the executive chairman of Pacton Gold. And Dale, it's always great to talk to you. How you doing?
Oh, doing well. Thanks a lot.
So lots of interesting things to talk about with the company. Pacton signing a letter of intent to acquire a 35% interest in another gold property adjacent to yours. Tell me a little bit about what you liked about this little area that you're acquiring.
Well, basically, you know, it had a lot of work done on it in the 1990s and early 2000s. There was like 82,000 meters of drilling, and it was a significant zone that they uncovered, or a couple of zones. But of course, they ran out of, you know, the gold market at that time. And I also like the fact that it's partnered with the major producer in the region. So, you know, it's a great partner. It's a high grade zone. There's some really high grade intersections at depth, and a lot of work done on it to date, and it fits within our strategy of drilling off high grade in well-known jurisdictions like Red Lake. And so and it's a 39.5% interest. We're the operator, and we plan on executing a pretty aggressive drilling program there as soon as possible.
So you hope to get that done this year?
Oh, for sure. We'd hope to be drilling as soon as we work out final details, sort of, and approvals from the partnership and permitting and whatnot. But I would anticipate within a couple of months we'd be drilling there.
Now, Dale, I want to ask about your property, of course, where this is adjacent to. Give me a latest update on what's happening on your property right now.
Well, currently on our main Red Lake properties, we are drilling south of Madsen, south of Pure Gold's Madsen mine that they're rebuilding. And the drill will probably move next to the actual northwest sort of line or fault line that extends from the LP fault, which is, of course, Great Bear's, where Great Bear's discoveries are. So finally, we've, built the access and have sort of winter conditions where we can come in there and drill that LP fault.
So it's interesting. You mentioned Pure Gold, you mentioned Great Bear as well, and now yourselves also, plus there are other companies that are operating in Red Lake. It is a topic of conversation these days over the last year, especially with the success that Pure Gold and Great Bear have had, obviously. Everyone's talking about Red Lake. It seems like it's one of the hottest jurisdictions right now in mining.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's always been a productive jurisdiction, but in terms of, the public and the market, it's become hot again, if you will, say in the last 2 years due to the Great Bear discovery, and that rejuvenated the area. I worked there in the late 1980s as a mine geologist for Dickinson Mines before it became Goldcorp. So, I mean, the area is been there, been producing for a long time, and has come up with new discoveries and new mines, but markets come and go. But the area has always been prolific, and now with Evolution Mining is buying out Newmont, we've got another injection of life, if you will, plus the Great Bear discoveries, plus Pure Gold's new mine. So there's a lot of activity, and I think Rubicon is rebuilding their mine as well. So there's four or five really, really active companies now.
And it helps with a good gold price as well.
Yeah, I mean, obviously that doesn't hurt. I mean, we have a $2,000 Canadian gold price, so a great time to be in Red Lake as far as I'm concerned.
Well, congratulations on this acquisition. We look forward to hearing more about it as the year rolls on. Dale, great to talk to you again. Have a good one.
Okay, thanks a lot.
All right, Goodbye. Dale Ginn, the executive chairman of Pacton Gold.